My name is Jimmy Colton. I am the photography editor at Sports Illustrated magazine in New York. My responsibilities include basically narrowing down a week's worth of images to illustrate the magazine on a weekly basis. We have 10 staff photographers that we send out to major events who shoot raw imagery. And in addition to our own photographers, we also receive on a weekly basis anywhere is on the upwards of 70 to 100,000 images that come in from sources such as Getty Images and AP, Reuters, freelancers, etc. So I physically look at probably close to a quarter million images a week to illustrate the most important stories for that particular issue. When I first started in the business 38 years ago at the Associated Press, the daily report was about 100 images, which included international news, sports, weather maps, graphics, the whole gamut. I have a very large monitor on my desk, which brings them up in contact sheet form. Each one is probably about 2 to 3 inches large. If someone did a retinal scan of my eyeballs, it would probably be dancing like a bear. What I do is I scan them very quickly. If there's something that intrigues me, I hotkey it to view a larger resolution in mid-res form. If I like it a lot, I have the opportunity to study it in a larger resolution. And then equally as quickly, I can hotkey it into a folder of selects. So that's basically 4 to 5 hours of my day sitting in front of a monitor, narrowing down these precious gems into a workable number. It was a real dynamic and diverse set of photographs. There were things as interesting as really well-lit and highly styled portraiture. There were some features in there. There was even some things that would fall under the category of photo illustration. My only fear when going through this amount of images is the heavy hand of Photoshop. And we have to be very, very careful that we don't take a photograph and turn it into an entirely different animal. There were not that many occasions where I felt the heavy hand of God was present, but there were a few. So we have to be extremely careful that what we're portraying as far as our imagery is concerned is relative to the truth of what was there. So that's just another piece of advice to the photographers that are either entering contests or trying to be published, that you don't want to recreate your image, you want to create an image. This particular photograph to me is a photo editor's dream. It has everything in it that you would want from a totally unexpected event. The driver is still in his cockpit, which is probably the only thing that is remaining intact, thank God, from this particular crash. You are looking at a photograph that is at a moment where after there's been some severe damage and this auto is in midair, the driver is still in his cockpit. His right hand, you can see clearly, is grabbing the steering wheel with all of his might. But you see all this other stuff that's going on around it. It was just absolutely fascinating. The engine is now exposed. A piece of a tire in the background is visible being thrown off into the distance. There's a gas line that is obviously emitting some liquid. I don't know whether it's gas or it doesn't look like oil, so I'm just very thankful that this thing didn't catch fire. But this photograph and the photographer managed to capture this particular moment in this sequence where all of this is visible and that it's tack sharp. Derek Simpson managed to capture in this particular photograph something that we call total serendipity. Whenever you have any kind of a sporting event where there's physical action between the competitors, you're looking for things like body motion that is captured. But then you get the totally unexpected things like reaction to an event. And this particular footballer is perfectly perpendicular and celebrating what I'm assuming is a goal or some happy event from this match. But what's really, really great about it is the way that it's framed. You've got him totally upside down and in beautiful light, and he's facing one of his players, and you can see the joy in the other player that is running onto the scene, and you can just barely see one of the opposing players in the background, and you can tell that he's got his arms to his head even though you can't see it. If that had been over just slightly to the left, this would have been a perfect picture. If you can bring a little fancy and a little lark and a little humor into the photography that you do, sometimes that can be a truly great selling point. This photograph is almost a biblical scene. The photographer, Lorenz, made a very conscious and I think well thought of decision to shoot this in black and white, or at least to portray this particular image in black and white. And what we have is probably hundreds of motorcyclers racing towards you, and they're forming a very graphic pattern. And what I love about the black and white is that it's split between the ocean, which is glistening in white off to the top right, and then you've got all of these athletes on their bikes coming at you, and it just sort of fades into the background. I think the photographer was also quite astute in realizing that there was a lot of sand being kicked up, and the fortunate part for him that it's semi-backlit. The best way to view something is from an angle that no one else gets to see, including the television. So this particular photograph shows the athletes in the beginning part of the triathlon in the swimming portion, but it's taken obviously from a helicopter or a fixed-wing aircraft, I'm not sure which. To me, almost looks like a painting. And this one was taken in color as opposed to black and white. This picture would not be as effective in black and white for the following reasons. One, the sort of tableau that's painted and the way that it's framed by the photographer is against a pure blue and really rich blue ocean. The competitors are all wearing black suits, but they're also all wearing white bathing caps. The one thing that makes this is the pop of the sort of pinkish-red canoe that's in the middle of the frame. This is a terrific example of a thinking photographer, someone who's looking for a different angle to portray this event, and graphically it's a stunner. Lindsey Vonn was, for us here in the States, a huge story during the Olympics, and she's one of the premier female skiers in the world. Skiing is one of the most difficult events to photograph because they are literally flying by you anywhere of upwards of 80 miles an hour if they're in the downhill. This particular photograph by Mitchell is terrific because he's managed to capture not only the essence of what skiing is about at a competition by looking at the form that Lindsey is taking on this particular turn, but also he was very, very smart in positioning himself into an area where he knew that sunlight is going to help his image a lot. The background is nice and clean. I cannot stress to you how important it is that in sports photography, the cleaner your background, the better the image is going to be. The triathletes dive into the water en masse, and that can be taken from a variety of angles. The beauty of this particular image is that you've got the reflection in the water before it's broken, the plane of the water is broken by any of the athletes. I believe there's one in the background, if you look very closely, whose hands have actually entered into the water. But he's managed to capture in this what appears to be several dozen people at the start of this. And it's so perfectly framed that it's got layers going from the top all the way to the bottom. When you take pictures at eye level, it's the way that you see the world, and nothing's really dynamic and interesting other than what you're seeing at your level. This photographer made it a point to get down fairly close to the ground, and I would say he's no more than maybe 6 inches to a foot off the ground, or as the camera is, I should say. And he waited for just the right moment for this dog sled to come from right to left. And he's framed it in such a way that you've got the mountains in the background, the musher actually riding the sled, and then he was extremely fortunate to have a black and a white dog running from right to left, and a beautiful, beautiful blue sky and the white snow underneath. The angle that he took this from is what makes this picture really genuinely dynamic, and the expressions of the dogs are priceless. This one, I actually feel like I'm riding on the skateboard with Sebastian. He's made it a point to shoot it at a slightly slower shutter speed, enough to retain the sharpness of the skateboard and the wheels and the very great detail of his sneakers, one of which is slightly turned, and you can see the pattern on the bottom. But the rest of the frame on the right, you actually feel like he's almost on ice because of the movement is causing the pavement to give this blurred effect or this motion effect. It's a combination of not only composition and content, but of color. This one is just one of those that scream out to me because of the red soles and the red sneakers that are the predominant element as far as the color is concerned. But the rest of it is muted and almost veiled in the sunlight that's hitting the ground. I'm assuming that this photograph was taken someplace where the dirt track itself is this beautiful red clay. And what's happened here is that he's managed to capture in this frame a really nicely composed image, because you've got the athlete on the bike himself frozen, and you can tell that from the tire wheels not moving, but the entire background is from when he's just made a turn and he's managed to kick up all of this red clay that is now being saturated by sunlight as he's making this turn. But the beauty, too, to this photograph is the top left corner. You can see that in the background there is some greenery, some trees and shrubbery. So you've got a palette here that sort of transcends all of the colors. This was a situation where the photographer, I think, was both good and lucky. This picture is of the bridge in Lisbon that is being crossed by marathoners, and it is being enveloped in a fog that has managed to eat up most of the remaining half of the bridge in the distance. But you can also see in the top of the frame some sort of land structure. So this is, as it is, a graphically stunning photograph. But what really, really adds to this element is the brightly colored helicopter in the lower left of this frame. Without it, I think it would still be an interesting photograph, but with it, it just makes it an even more dynamic photograph. Whenever you can add another element to something graphically and compositionally that brings a sense of place, brings a sense of dimension, and that's exactly what this does. Being a dedicated photo editor for a sports magazine, there are certain criteria that we look for. But as far as photography is concerned, there are still some basics that transcend all forms of the genre. I usually call it the three C's, which are content, composition, and color. And I use the word color not in the literal sense of color or black and white, but also in a very figurative sense, meaning emotion or feel. So if it hits one of those categories, it's usually a good picture. If it hits multiple categories, it's a great picture. And if it hits all three of those categories, it's an outstanding picture. Content is critical, whether it's a news photograph or a sports photograph. It's basically the peak moment that we're trying to illustrate. So if there is the game-winning touchdown, we are hoping that we have it. It's the catch, or it's the kick, or it's the point that was critical in that particular game. Composition is a very critical element of photography. We have to remember that we see everything from eye level. So to me, most pictures that are taken standing up or at eye level are pretty pedestrian, fairly ordinary. And for us to actually be moved by a picture, it's generally from an angle that we have not seen. It may be a camera that is from a remote position that a human being can't be, hanging over the rafters at a basketball game. It may be a remote that's placed underneath a steeplechase event. The third C being color can be in a literal sense of where you have something that is visually pleasing as far as tonality is concerned. And then off in a corner, there might be something that just jumps out as far as the color. A sea of blue and then in a red buoy or a red boat off in the corner or something of that effect. Or it can be just something as simple as toning a photograph. Running something in black and white as opposed to color is a decision and an aesthetic decision that a photographer makes when presenting their image. And on the figurative sense, color can be something as simple as emotion and drama that you manage to capture in an image. So I would call that category, probably the tears and cheers, the celebration of the moment of victory and the agony of defeat, literally. And you can get some great pictures that illustrate the emotion or the feel or the color of an event that is equally as important as the content and the composition. I tell this to a lot of young up-and-coming photographers, and if they're listening, please pay heed. One of the best things that you can do is try to get together a portfolio of portraiture, because that's the one medium that every magazine, newspaper, wire service, every publication is going to be in need of good portraiture. It spans the sports world, the news world, international, etc. So I do encourage photographers to try to come up with a stylistic approach as far as their portraits are concerned, and they will wind up getting work.